guys, welcome back to the channel. We're going to start out today by doing a couple of pass-bys. It's been long overdue. I've been wanting to see how this thing runs for quite a while. So we're going to start this video out by doing so. But before we do that, let me show you the tires that we got on the car the other night. We put on the Tiger Paws all around. Took out to my pop's house. He helped me put them on there. And I'll include some clips in this video of us putting the tires on. But anyway, let's just get to it. Guys, we are back at the garage. I had a good time. I don't know about you guys and watching the drive-bys, but I thought the car drove pretty good. It sounded good, but now we're back and we're going to go ahead and finish up what we started on this door and getting this fake leather back attached to the door again. So I've got some adhesive spray. So 3M spray number 77, I believe. I used it on something else a while back. I have a little bit left, so I'm gonna go ahead and get this taped up so we don't spray all over the door, and we'll go ahead and get this finished up. All right, so we're gonna use some painter's tape. You've seen me use this before. In fact, it's the frog tape, which I really enjoy this stuff. It doesn't leave any sticky residue on what you're painting, and it is pretty strong. It sticks to the wall of your house or whatever it may be pretty easily. Plus it's nice and thick. So I'll go ahead and put this around the edges, and then we'll get to spraying. I probably could have done this with the this door insert still on the car. I probably didn't have to take it off, but that's all right. So they're talking about how well it sticks, and for whatever reason it doesn't want to stick down right here. Of course, it's pretty cold out here today. Winter is definitely right around the corner. I didn't expect this car to take as long as it has to get done. Of course, a lot of that is due to my work schedule, but it's been a fun ride so far, and we may just hang on to it for a while and just keep doing things to it once it's done. You guys just let me know in the comments section what you guys like to see done to the car. And we'll just kind of make this our fun build as we go. And I also have another project in line that I will debut in a very near video. It's actually a vehicle that I started working on a few years ago that's been in the family, so it's not a rebuild, well, it's a rebuild, but more restoration. So I'll show you that in the near future here. There's not one to stick on this corner, so there must be something on the door. Dirt or grime or something. I probably should have wiped this down first, but we're not going to be spraying on this part, so I think we'll be okay. All right, I'm going to go grab my spray, and I'll be right back. All right, so here's the spray I'm going to use. This is just what's left over from another project I had. It's the 3M Super 77. It's supposed to work on pretty much everything. Foil, foam, paper, metal, plastic, fabric, cardboard, insulation. And so we'll give this a try, see if this will hold that pleather onto the door. And it is pretty stinky stuff, so I'm gonna go ahead and go grab my mask and we'll get this sprayed down.
Go ahead and kind of pull this up. So we go ahead and just get all the bubbles out from under it. There we go. Alright, so I'm going to spray this down. And it says to wait about 5 minutes to let it get tacky. And then we will push this down. And I have a little plastic thing here to kind of get it nice and flat, and then to tuck in the corners. All right, here we go. All right, well, I'll let that sit a little bit before we push it down. And then we'll be right back.
All right, guys, so it's been a few minutes. I'm gonna go ahead and start pressing the material down to the door and getting all the bubbles out. And then we'll use this spatula thing to kind of tuck the corners in. Let's start right here in the middle. Get like a credit card or something that's a little bit thinner. All right, there we go. That should work a little bit better. Clean the plastic up around the area we worked on here. All right, so besides of where it was super glued before, I think it came out pretty good. Nice and flat, don't have any bubbles. But yeah, I still got super glue up here, I don't know. But other than that, it definitely looks better than it did before. So, or there's the finished product. Let's go ahead and get it back on the car. Okay, so we got the car in the garage, or mostly in the garage. It's nice and cold and rainy, but let's go ahead and get this trim back onto the door here. Easy enough. And let's plug everything back in. Guys, and there you have it. A completed door. Looks a lot better than it did before. And everything works. So, alright, we'll scratch this off the list and move on to the next thing. Alright, guys, so now we have the door put back together. I'm going to go ahead and work on this back bumper and try to sand down that clear coat and smooth it out and see if we can get it looking somewhat decent. I've got a feeling we're going to have to just go ahead and sand all the whole bumper down and repaint the whole bumper. But we'll give it a shot first. I'm going to use some 1500 grit and wet sand it. Then I'll use some 2000 grit. We'll see what it looks like. Probably won't get a whole lot done tonight because it's already getting dark. It's in the 40s and it's actually supposed to snow tomorrow. So we'll see what we can get done tonight and go from there. Oh, and right before we start working on this, I'll go ahead and splice in some clips of changing the tires the other night. Down, three to go, huh? Guys, it is a lot smoother to touch. I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to 2000 grit, go over it one more time, and then we'll see what it looks like. All right, here's 2000 grit. so you can obviously still tell where we painted. Very distinct line right there. I don't know if this will polish up or not. It's worth a shot just to kind of experiment with it. But if we can't get it looking good, then we'll go ahead and just repaint the whole thing. Of course, now we're fighting winter weather, so hopefully it won't delay us too much. But to the touch, though, it feels nice and smooth where it was rough. It felt like almost like sandpaper before. So they may polish up. We'll see. All right, guys. So it's getting pretty cold. It's starting to get dark. So we'll go ahead and close this episode out. And hopefully the weather doesn't get as bad as they're saying it's going to. So we can continue to work on this and get it done. If so, we may have to maneuver some cars out of the way and get it back in the garage and try to work on it in the garage. But anyway, thanks for watching today's episode. Hope you've enjoyed the project so far. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to like and subscribe if you like the content. And we'll see you guys next time on Casey's Garage. Peace.